Hi guys, it's Kamal. Welcome back to my channel. If you haven't already done so, please subscribe. Help me to build my channel. So today, I want to talk about some ways that we can deal with anger. Because this is something that plagues the society. This person is so easily angered. And when they become angry, they don't really know how to contain it. They don't know what to do with it, and they end up unleashing it onto others and sometimes causing much hurt and even death. So anger is something that we have to learn to deal with. Now, ever since I was little, people always tell me, you know, you're a cool cucumber. It's like you don't lose your cool ever. This is not true. There have been times when I've lost my cool, but I think for the most part it is true, because I do practice a lot of affirmations, meditation, and I try to be in control of my spirit and my emotions. So I really don't become angry easily, and if I am angry, I find ways to express it in a way that persons don't get hurt. And I think we need to learn how to do that. So let me share with you how I deal with my anger or my resentment or whenever I feel I've been wronged. The very first thing I tend to do is to cry. Now, I'm a firm believer in crying, and I don't think crying is a bad thing at all. I embrace the crying. So don't feel sorry for me if you see me crying. That's my strength. When I get angry, I will cry. And I guess persons would interpret this as me being soft or conceding victory. It is not. It is just, it actually is my strength, because when I cry, when I release that, I'm untouchable after that. There's nothing you can do that will hurt me after that. I unleash that in tears. You know, there's something in the water. I always say there's something in salt water. There's something in the sweat and the tears and the seawater that is cleansing and healing, and it allows you to just flush it out. So after I cry, whether it's for a 5-minute spell, or I'll cry for an hour, or I'll be crying on and off for days, because I don't mind, I'll cry in public, I'll cry while I'm walking down the road, okay? I have no qualms about crying. I'll cry in a car, I'll cry in the supermarket, I'll cry wherever I feel I need to cry. Whenever I'll cry while I'm doing my laps, if it needs to be done. But once it's over, I feel so strong, I feel so ready to go again. So that is my first go-to solution. I just cry it out, and I find a way to deal with it on the inside. That's my strength, that's my power. The second thing I will do is I will reflect. So I'll go to a quiet place, you know, I'll just think about the situation, you know, what really happened, did I overreact, did the other person overreact, where are they coming from, what are they going through, maybe I can try and understand it from their perspective. So I do reflect a lot. And I try to see things from the other person's point of view. And I try to imagine that, hey, maybe it has nothing to do with me. Maybe it's just something they're going through. Maybe it's just something that, maybe yes, I triggered something in them, but it's for them to resolve, not necessarily for me to resolve. So I've always been a person of reflection. And sometimes you don't even need to go to the person. It's just you deal with your side. Let them deal with their side. The third thing I will do, if I am very angry at you, what I will tend to do, I'll delete your number from my phone. I'll delete your contact. And the reason I do this is to stop myself from reaching out to you accidentally, or even just in a moment of weakness, I might call. So to prevent all of that, I will just delete the contact, right? Maybe I'll add it later on when I calm down. But I tend to do that, find myself doing that. If I'm angry at you, you no longer exist in my phone, you no longer exist on my social media. That's just how I am. And like I said, sometimes it's a way of protecting the other person too, because depending on the mood I'm in, if I do call the person, I'm going to cuss them out. And I'm going to probably say things that I'm going to regret. So to prevent all of that, I just delete the contact. And like I said, maybe later on I'll add them back. Number four, let's say it's a social media friend. And I feel the person has offended me or has made me angry. I will unfriend the person. And maybe you think this is petty, but this is just my way. I will unfriend the person, or I will block the person, or I will just stop notifications from the person, maybe for a while. Because, similar to the third point, it's just my way of just not having contact with the person, right? I don't want to accidentally, I don't want to be scrolling and see a post that I find funny and I go like it, and then I said, damn, why did I like? I don't want that to happen, so I just remove the possibility of it happening. So you will be blocked or unfriended or stop notification, depending on who you are and how much you mean to me and what the situation was and what you did. So for example, if I comment on your post, and this is getting into petty now, but I don't care. If I comment on your post, and other people comment on your post, and you respond to everybody else but me, I stop notifications from your page. Because I don't want myself to be in the position to see your post again and comment. I don't want to put myself through that again and have to deal with you ignoring me. So I just stop notifications, so I don't see anything from you, so I'm not tempted to comment. Petty, I know. Now, the fifth thing, depending on who and what, so I might actually say, okay, let's talk. I might, because usually I try to deal with things on my inside, just me deal with it. That's how I pretty much go about it. But if it's a case where, let's say it's your spouse or your partner, in that case, or your child, or you know, somebody close to you, then you might have to actually sit with the person and talk about it. I'm not a talker, so maybe that's why this is number five on my list. I'm not a talker. I'm more internal. I'm more trying to see what's my role and sorting out myself. Maybe a more extroverted person might have talking as their number one thing to do, right? So it depends on you. So in the case where I see where dialogue is needed, because you see, the thing is, I rely more on my intuition than on what somebody else is going to say to me. So maybe that's why talking is so far down on my list. I will more go with what my spirit is saying to me, as opposed to what the other person is going to try to explain. But yes, talking might be necessary at some point. Number seven, I try to find a creative way to express. So I might draw. I love to draw, I love to do craft, and this just frees up some space in my head, you know, and allows me to express it without having to call in someone else, because these creative ways of expression, they do allow you to unleash. Number eight, I sing. Yes, I sing. I sing in the shower, I might sing while I'm doing chores, I just sing. And this is something I enjoy doing, actually. I love to sing. It gives me a lot of comfort and enjoyment. I will sing a song over, and if it's a song that I love, just like how I would play the song 10, 20 times, I'll be singing it 10, 20 times. I think my children probably get tired of me sometimes with that. But it's my way of dealing with things, to just singing it out. Number nine, I might do some exercise or some martial arts training. Once you're doing something physical, you know, you're building something, you're exercising, you're training, this is also a way to unleash all of that pent-up emotion. Number 10, if all else fails, then, you know, if you try to talking, you try to singing, you try to crying, you try everything else, and nothing else is gonna calm you down, then number 10, you actually have to find that person and give them a good punch. You have to find that person and give them a good punch. That's the only way sometimes to just deal with the situation. You know I'm joking, right? I'm joking. Don't punch anybody. Just get a punching bag, get a pillow, get anything that can take the punch. Anything inanimate that can take the punch. Don't go looking for anyone and say, come on, say I must come look for you, because that's the only way. Don't, please don't do that. Get a pillow and just keep punching the pillow. Even if you have to put the person's face on the pillow, glue, staple the face and punch, punch, punch till you get it out. Right, but that too is a last resort. But seriously speaking, you know, find some way to get it out, but don't, apart from confrontation. Confrontation is not the way, and we have to find more mature ways of dealing with our issues. It can't be the first thing come to your head is to just fist it out. We have to find ways to deal with it in ourselves, or to include the other person, to talk to the other person, ask them, why did you do that? Why did you say that? What did I do? Because it could be my fault, it could be just an issue with them, and I just happen to be there, and they're taking it out on me. It could be that, right? So, those are my 10 suggestions. That's how I deal with it. My number one thing, just cry it out on my own, and that works most of the time. And as soon as I'm done with that, I am just ready to go. And sometimes I actually feel I'm untouchable when it comes to that, because I have that mechanism in place. There's hardly anything anyone can say or do that will affect me. Beyond just a minute, and I deal with it through my tears. I flush it out, and then I'm ready to go again. And actually, if I have something else to do, because I'm always on my mission, so whether I'm depressed, I'm sad, I'm angry, my life goes on. The other things go on, right? They're not stalled in any way. All right, so I hope you find this useful. If you think someone else might find it useful, please share. Please subscribe to my page if you haven't done so already, and I'll see you next time.